Well, hello fellow vloggers, or anyone else who takes an interest in watching this video. It's all much appreciated. What makes the world go round, gives us all something to listen to and whatever. I'm going to talk about suspension setup. I've just adjusted up the preload in this bike and ridden a few miles on it. Real simple setup in this bike. The front is not adjustable, so you just forget about it, and the rear only has preload adjustment. Now, from standard to the maximum hardness, stiffness is 30 clicks from the standard, so I've taken it up 15, and to be honest, it's transformed the bike. It feels so much more positive, the more feedback, everything, and that's only with the preload setting. I haven't taken it up any, I don't think I want to take it up any further than that. I don't want to ruin the comfort of this bike, and there is a notable difference in stiffness in the bike, but still retains quite a bit of comfort, and that's what you want when you've got this type of bike. So that 15 clicks seems to be the job so far. I stopped at tracking lines in the road, which it was doing. Just gives it a far more positive feel. Some of the bikes have serious amount of settings for suspension. You have preload and rebound, dampen, preload, rebound, compression, dampen on the front and on the rear. It takes a lot of knowledge to get it right. For most road riders, the standard setting's not far away. Thing that about me with this, the preload in this, thing is, I'm quite heavy, so it's sort of needed, you know, to beef that up a bit. But I'll say that. It's something that I'd do, but say with a lighter rider you can maybe even back it off a bit, but the standard setting's always going to be pretty good. Okay, if you're a talented rider, I suppose you can, you will know what to do and adjust, but understanding it all is quite difficult. Hopefully this will inspire someone to give us a whole rundown of what the reactions are of each one. You know, the compression damping is, you know, what'll give it resistance when it's, you know, under basically dipping, and rebound damping is the resistance when it the springs bring it back up again. Certainly it all has the effect to make it harder. So, yeah, I know that basic principle, but the subtleties of it all, I'm sure you can really upset your bike if you do get it wrong. I say that I do always go with a bit more preload, but say that's obvious because I'm heavy. Sprint GT that I had before this, and that actually upped the rebound damping. I don't think there was no compression damping adjustment on it, but there was rebound damping, and I upped it as well. Again, that transformed the bike, but I did a step by step without, you know, without forgetting where I've taken it from, so that was always the way. Take it step by step, remember your last setting, if it feels worse, go back to it. But again, that's what the boys that race do, you know, they actually up their settings, and then if it has made things worse, they go back, they work backwards. So there you go. But anyone feel like giving us a rundown who totally understands this, it would be much appreciated just to learn, and it's great for us to learn of each other. I'll say it's a good thing. The top gear roll on this bike is some fantastic. I'll say just to accelerate past that car was just top gear roll on mid range. Quite an amazing thing for me stepping down the CCs and finding more of a top gear roll on. Although the thing would be, it is actually revving harder than the bigger capacity bikes. But being a three cylinder, it never feels as though it's revving hard. Today's the day of the Tandragee 100 road races. I was going to go to them. I usually flag at them, but I wasn't available on the practice night, so I haven't been called. So that gives me the day to do whatever I want. Actually, don't think I'll go because I really want to spin out in the bike rather than sit and watch. You know, so it's good luck to everyone who's racing. Hope they have a safe day. It's quite a dangerous course. Well, every one of them's a dangerous course. Even the short circuit's a dangerous course nowadays. But the road racing's quite dangerous. I must do a video around the course at some stage. Just to trundle around, not at any great speed, just trundle around it and let you see the course. It is absolutely fabulous. That's barely everything. Long straights, real tight, twisty stuff, jumps. It's probably one of the most technical courses you could ever come across, but again, all that technical bit also adds to the danger. I was at a track day at Kirkeston. I'm sure you saw the video, Big D's track day, and I was never a great fan of short circuits, but I have to say it was actually quite good because you could actually see around quite a few corners, you could see a lot more. I must go and take one in again. That should be a good day. And I suppose you also have all the catering facilities sitting right beside you, so that's always a plus point too. So I must keep an eye out and maybe go to one. They having all those facilities fairly helps. Just into Tandragee now, the home of the potato crisps. It's just on the right hand side. It is actually a big castle. That's fabulous cheese and onion. In England, Scotland, Wales, you'll get Golden Wonder, who is now owned by Tato, and I think they've modified their flavours to be more like Tato. Not such a bad thing, so you ever grab a packet in England, quite tasty. Although, of course, we all know potato crisps are not good for you. Give a nod to a learner. Just passing the right hand side, GM tires, in Tandragee. That's where I get all my tires. I'll sit there. Now, they sponsored our last bike run, so I do think they're worth a shout out. Our club's last bike run, so they sponsored it and provided a hog roast. Apparently it went down really well. The boys are good fun. One of the owners actually rides a bike, and you'll always get a bit of fun. Good thing about them is, now they'll take the wheel out of your bike, but the good thing about them is the way they look after your bike. When I take the wheel out, everything is covered, all the attachments on the machines for taking your wheel off, and or to taking your tire off the rim, and nothing is damaged. Did a fabulous job that way. When putting things back together, right, comes the book of settings, and I get the torque right and torque everything up to the required settings. I say, look after your bike as you would yourself, which is absolutely fabulous. Even when I had a bike with a strange setup, a K1200R Sport BMW, they actually made attachments for one of their stands to accommodate the bike. Absolutely fabulous. So if you need tires and you want your bike looked after and just ride in, ride out, thing, they're the boys to go to. So is this boy breaking for? He's just looking for somewhere. But ride in, ride out, and I'll say competitive prices, they're as cheap as anywhere else. So sometimes a lot cheaper. I'll say you'll get a bit of fun while you're at it. One of my favourite roads is the one that goes from Tandragee in Europe. But all pretty good surface, and oh, sick wanker. That's me heading for home now. Had a bit of a look round. Glad I didn't go to the Tandragee races. Unfortunately, someone had got killed on it. The family of the guy wanted the racing to continue, so it has done, but it just takes the edge of everything. It's something that would certainly put me off. So I'm glad I didn't go. Had a bit of a spin around, but crossings up Mayo Bridge has a sail on, some nice kit in it. Didn't buy anything, thankfully. Then I came down, went in by Wes McCrum's place, had a cup of tea. Had some nice gear in there. So, if you were looking at a bike, it'd be certainly worth a visit. And then just dropped into McCallum, sir, just to have a nose round. But the forecast of the weather is to go to turn and get a bit wet. So I'm heading for home. I'll just get the in before it gets soaked. So I've got a waterproof jacket on, I've got leggings and the back of the bike, but that is still, I couldn't be bothered with it, so that's it. I enjoyed my little spin out, and Had a couple of wee twisty roads with the suspension now beefed up a bit, and it seems to have made all the difference. On bumpy stuff, yeah, you do notice the difference, but still, that's a compromise, isn't it? So, there you go. But that's, I will put also in a plank in a car, not concentrating, coming, just driving on the wrong side of the road, and then just at the last minute noticing me. An absolute balloon. But, yeah, well, that's what they have to face. But from now, folks, ride safe, and talk to you soon. Gary GSF signing off.